In the universe of Dune, the Fremen lived almost entirely underground. Those cities could house thousands, with living quarters, ceremony spaces, and even internal industries.
But hey, is it possible to recreate modern underground cities? Can we move Singapore fully underground?
To answer that question, let's first take a look at what's already below the ground. In order to maximise our limited land space, Singapore's subterranean space runs deep. We have telecom cables that connect calls and give us internet access. Further below lies underground shopping malls and pedestrian networks. And nearly 10% of Singapore's expressways are beneath the ground. About 70% of our railway is also underground. There's also Singapore's sewerage system, supply cables, and even a liquid hydrocarbons reserve, which has freed up to 600 Olympic-sized swimming pools worth of space above the ground. And while its depth has never been disclosed, the underground emanation facility has also freed up 400 football fields worth of space on land. Singapore is projected to have a population of at least 6.5 million by 2030, which means we will need to increase our current supply of land by about 7%. Is moving everything underground a possible solution? The four biggest components of land use are predicted to be four: defense, housing, industry and commerce, and land transport. And at first glance, it seems possible to move most of our infrastructure underground. For starters, we have the technology to dig deep. In Singapore, the tunnel boring machine that barreled our MRT lines is the same machine used to construct the longest and deepest railway tunnel in the world, the Gotthard Base Tunnel. The tunnel runs 57 kilometres long and is about 2.5 kilometres deep, which is much deeper than the tallest building in Singapore, Guoco Tower. The geology in Singapore is largely made up of the following types of rocks, with Bukit Timah Granite being the hardest, and the TBM is able to power through them all. Besides, technology to build cities underground already exists. One example is Montreal's Underground City, which spans over 32 kilometres and consists of shopping centres, offices, hotels and even universities. It was built so that residents could move around without facing the cold during harsh winters. Another example is Beijing's Dixiacheng, which was built to protect the city from nuclear attacks back in the 1970s and is now a tourist attraction. Though not officially confirmed, it was said to be able to accommodate 6 million inhabitants and was even equipped with factories, grain and oil warehouses, and a mushroom cultivation farm. And besides, there are surprising benefits to building underground. As weather conditions become more extreme, going underground could protect our buildings from weather erosion. Temperatures underground are also more consistent and less prone to fluctuations. Lastly, it is interesting to note that underground spaces, especially deep ones, are far less vulnerable to earthquakes than superficial buildings. However, Singapore's year-long rainfall and high temperatures could have eroded our underground geology more than we think. While it's not impossible to work with, the difficulty increases as more support systems are needed to ensure it will not collapse inwards. Building underground is also a lot more complex. Unlike building on land, underground structures cannot be taken down once developed. So detailed 3D data is required to plan for specific uses. Underground plans would also compete with existing overground projects, especially because underground projects often involve the blasting of rocks, which will be difficult in densely populated areas. And lastly, people simply enjoy being under the sun. A study even showed that operating room nurses, who work long hours in limited sunlight exposure, exhibit poorer mental health than other populations. Underground infrastructures will still be built out of necessity. But a future where Singapore goes completely underground? That seems unlikely for now. But even when most living spaces stay above ground, we will continue to expand downwards for underground reserves and communal spaces. In fact, earlier this year, we just completed our first underground service reservoir. Located directly underneath a park, it is slated to serve more than 8,000 households. An underground link is also in the works to connect the future Changi Airport Terminal 5 with the existing Terminal 2. So who knows? We may eventually live underground in the future and learn a thing or two from the family.